ब्रह्मांड विदधाति पूर्व योई वेदादुच्छ प्रशिनोति तस्मै संभदेवं आत्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षु शरणमहं प्रपद्ये. Adore and surrender to the lotus feet of the Supreme Force who generated the primogeniture of the cosmos and who instilled the seed of the root of wisdom, the primeval elements of wisdom inside him, and who is responsible for the stimulation of the auto-intellectual instinct to the aspirants of emancipation. I surrender to him. Taking into consideration the topic today, the inaugural address, not only as a methodology by which as a Swamiji we have to render our blessings for a successful venture with the institutions we have commenced, summarizing the various levels of perception in both the sides of knowledge or both the parts of knowledge, or hemispheres of knowledge. First, let us commence with the definition of science, and then with spiritualism, and the interrelativity of spiritualism with religion and philosophy, then coming into history of cosmology as perceived by different schools of thought, and also specially focusing on gravity and history of gravitational theory, as well as the observation of the same gravity by the astronomers and the Vedic seers, as well as adumbrating the glimpse of the unexplorable and explored regions of the gravitational force and gravity to both the ends, and the purpose of research or study of gravity, as well as the purpose of conducting such seminars. This is the methodology, or this is the way by which we want to summarize the concept as the inaugural address. So jigyasa, jnana ichha, jigyasa, knowing about his own physical stature, which has the end in knowing about the cosmophysical body, the macrocosmical body, the rat, the rupa, Brahman, the ultimate reality. So depending upon his caliber and his capability and accessibility, the taste of a person's pursuit towards wisdom is defined and derived. Science, basically, any informative or any compendium of authoritative and empirical information that is meant for the welfare of the mankind in long run, that reveals the mysteries, puzzles, riddles, and the explorabilities of the surroundings, that is not a science. Science is an art. Science is an attempt. Science is a finance. Science is an austerity. Science is a compilation of observations, experiments, excavations, and implementations of various theoretical and technological backgrounds bearing by the person gets relieved from nescience and insufficiency of the evil impacts of nescience, oblivion, false apprehension, misapprehension, etc. So that is not a science. Science is the indubitable compendium of sources of knowledge on any faculty, on any field. So it is vast, it is endless. So says the Vedas, Anantavai Veda, it is endless. Even though the categorization of the Vedas are found to be four, Anantavai Veda, there are infinite and immeasurable resources of knowledge. So the Vedas are also infinite and immeasurable. The pursuit of Vedas, here it has been well explained that one deals with the creator and other deals with the creation. But we have to understand, as per the statement of Max Planck, he will say, for religion, God is at the beginning, or for science, he is at the end. That is the statement of Max Planck. So, knowing about the fundamental factor and explaining and experiencing the derivative factors is spiritualism. Knowing about the fundamental factor, experiencing and yet explained and elucidated about the derivatives is spiritualism. Knowing about the derivative factors and trying to know and perceive about the fundamental factor is science. So here, knowing the fundamental unit, yena vijnanena sarva vijnanam bhavati, by knowing the preliminary navel factor by which all these things are managed and emancipated. A clear vision, the vision with purity, clarity, the expression with articulate and ascertained background is there in the spiritual philosophy. The problem may be the scarcity of availability of such philosophers who are ambiversatile or multiversatile, and moreover the tradition being very esoteric rather than exotic. So the differences of science and philosophy of spiritualism, we have to now classify. First, spiritualism is a study of the imperceptible force. The concept of spiritualism or spirituality has been lexicographically derived from a chemical attribute known as spirit. So the unseen driving force that acts and activates upon the various observations in a laboratory, which was named as spirit, has been attributed to the unseen driving force in all mechanisms. So that is why the mechanism of soul or ontology has been attributed with the spirit, and then as a relative finite of words, spiritualism, spirituality, spiritualism, etc. So the spiritualism is the study of the fundamental spirit. Then in the second stage comes philosophy, third is a religion. They are not different from each other, but their coverage is vast. If you see spirituality, understanding or an attempt to understand the primitive force, primordial force, then it encompasses the whole globe. If it is taken into account, philosophy, what is philosophy? It is very simple, derived from the same etymological root of philosophia, which means love or craving for knowledge. That is, philo-anthropic means love towards fellow human beings. So craving towards knowledge is philosophy. So as the presidential address clearly evinces that philosophy encompasses anything, it may be in social sciences, humanitarian sciences, life sciences, everything it encompasses, even cookery, it has its own philosophy, those who love cooking. So love towards knowledge is philosophy. But still, even though gentleness is considered to be wealth or richness, part of richness, a person owing that negligible money or owning that money cannot be considered as rich, because it requires a considerable amount for fixing that nomenclature. A person who is possessing a negligible amount of a phenomena, even though there may be possession, there must be a considerable and also an abundant possession to be befitting to the nomenclature. Just as richness is there even in meager wealth. People are joyful to be aristocratic, plutocratic and rich only if they gain a considerable status of wealth position. Likewise, love towards knowledge is very much observable in the form of craving towards various portions of science by various types of people as well as the proclivity of their intellectual inclination. But still, that which is on the basis of the foundation thought for understanding the fundamentals of universe, that deserves to be called as philosophy. Even though philosophy, as per academic pursuit, lexicographic understanding and etymological derivation, it can denote any faculty in which there is an attempt towards an innovative approach for gaining knowledge, that which tends to reach a person at a such level where the person gets consummate wisdom, perplenary wisdom, which gives him perennial source of the fruits of wisdom and perpetual joy. Every faculty, everything that can theoretically be pronounced as philosophy, that which removes the person from the hurdles of suspicion, oblivion, false apprehension and deception and various other productive measures and other byproducts which are there in the path of illusion, that which is said to be so, that is worthy enough to be called as knowledge. And philosophy is the study of pursuit of such a knowledge which is all correct. So third comes to religion. Religion is an area where there is a code of conduct and principle which attributes the person to a pathway, that is, having a particular theoretical approach and also a conviction about the fundamental reality, that is the tattva, the means for attainment of the fundamental reality and realization, that is the gita, and the fruits of the realization and dissemination as purusha. So as per the definition given by the ancient matasthapatas, the primordial receptors of our transcendental philosophical schools and standards, they clearly carved and culminated the level of perfection to religion. Even though that is misinterpreted, misconceived and malpracticed, religion is the highest standard of order, and religion gives you proximity to God. Spiritualism, it is in a remote sensory perception value, and philosophy that has intensive perception value and proximate and particularly perception value is with religion. So spiritualism gives the way of understanding the imperceptible, the Brahman or Supreme Reality, and philosophy is a source of knowledge which combines various types of approaches. For example, philosophy, it has five major divisions. There are more than 630 divisions of philosophy. There are five major divisions. One is ontology, the study towards the fundamental concept of each and every behavior and each and every structure. It is ontology. Epistemology, the study of origin, evolution, expansion, and evolution or retransmission of wisdom. Epistemology. Metaphysics, that which deals with the exposure and experience of that which is unscrutable and impalpable to human limited sensory organs or limited intellect and perceptible values. That is epistemology. Then the fourth thing is cosmology, the study of evolution of the world. That is evolution, the sustenance by means of rotation and revolution in axis and orbit. Then getting into dissolution, in which it is converted into a microcosmic enzyme. So in Vishishta Advaita, Vishishtasya Brahmana Advaitam Vishishta Advaitam. In our philosophy, we used to call the Vishishta Brahman. The super sentient being embedded and embellished with the sentient and insentient being, the Chetra Chetra Vishishta Brahman. At the time of emancipation, at the time of emanation as well as expansion, it is Stula Chidadit Vishishta Brahman. It is tangible and it is macrocosmic. At the time of dissolution, it is becoming microcosmic. So the microcosmic and macrocosmic exposure, which deals with the hot and cold dark matter synthesis and primordial synthesis of the Riemannian zebra, as well as the Big Bang conjecture, is being explained by Vishishta Advaita Siddhanta in the form of Stula Chidadit Vishishta Brahma and Sukshma Chidadit Vishishta Brahma, the macrocosmic and microcosmic inheritation of the Supreme, the ultimate reality. So here, it is explained in cosmology. And the fifth is eschatology. We deal with the interval. Human life is nothing but the interval between his life and death. Then eschatology is a science which perceives the second interval between his death and rebirth. That which deals with the process of transmigration. That which believes the perpetual cycle of transmigration, that there is a time immemorial causal relation which puts them into effect, and the effect being cause of a second cyclic cause. So this perpetual arrangement of mutual law, reliability, liability and responsibility of the karmic body is studied in eschatology. So the philosophy in higher standard, it deals with cosmology, eschatology, metaphysics, epistemology and ontology. So this is known as philosophy. And I was very much confused about this subject. And it has been clearly mentioned that it is on Indian thought. Because philosophy is a science which deals with imperceptibility. And the physics gravity that deals with the behavior of mutual annihilation, our attitude of mutual attraction that exists between particles, massive particles. So this everything can be combined in the sense of primordial approach or ultimate approach, that is entirely different. Taking into consideration the proximate values or peripheral or apparent approach, it is very difficult to mingle both these things. Philosophy, generally Indian philosophy, philosophy means Vedanta. The essence of Veda, what we call is philosophy. Philosophy generally refers to Vedanta, as per the Indian tradition and lineage. In the vast sense, vaster sense and vaster sense, we can see three different types of philosophy. In vast sense, it deals with the five schools of thought and the five disciplines of thought which are clearly depicted now. And in the vaster sense, it covers the six schools of thought. One is the Nayayika, the logistic school of thought, founded by Gautama. Second is the Vaisheshika Shastra, which is elucidated by Anada. There is a qualified mechanism or quantum mechanism in which he put the Paramanuvada. The Paramanuvada, that is the theory of the atomic base or nuclear base, that is the first atomic theory, was founded only by Vaisheshika Kanada, not by Dalton. And the first model had been depicted only by him, not by the Bohr's atomic model, which is very much popular in our physics class. So, it is the Kanada school of thought which deals with the atomic and subatomic theory, Anu and Paramanuva. The third thing is the Sankhya, or the epistemological survey, which Sankhya Buddhi Dhyana. So he deals with this. The Sankhya philosophy which is the communion of Pradhana and Purusha, matter with Purusha, the individual being responsible for the cosmic function, which is given by Kapilacharya. Then came the Yoga school of thought of Patanjali, in which there is an Ishwara, Tasya Vachapranamaha. So says Patanjali, there is a controller, there is a supercomputer and master brain, and the hyper mind behind this control of this universe. It is not accidental, incidental, coincidental, collective, individual, or something else. So it is properly manipulated, managed, administered by the hyper sentient force acting on it. So that is the Seshwara Yoga Vada of Patanjali. Then came the two major schools of thought, Purva Mimamsa of Jaimini, which deals with the ritualistic portions of application. Then came the Uttara Mimamsa of Vadarayana, Krishnadvaitayana, Vyasa, which is now popularly known as Vedanta philosophy, which is commented by all Madhacharyas like Vaskaracharya, Yadav Prakashacharya, Ramanuja, Vandabha, Nimbarja, Swaminarayana, Shankaracharya, Madhvacharya, in the forms of their respective philosophies, known as Shuddhadvaita, Bhavadvaita, Tattvadvaita, Dvaitadvaita, Achitya Veda, Veda, Veda Veda, Vishikadvaita, Dvaita, etc. So this is in vaster sense. The vastest sense of philosophy is into the philosophy of Bertrand Russell, Immanuel Kant, which are most probably their non-theistic as well as atheistic principles, or even the theistic principles of great scholars like Immanuel Kant, etc. And even the philosophy that existed in our country, Charvaka. Then the Jaina philosophy, which is known as Arhata, and four schools of thought of Buddhism known as Vaibhashika, Sautrantika, Madhyamika, and Yogacharya. Apart from which, there is Bhatta and Prabhakara, two schools of thought, and also the Pashupata, which is belonging to the Pashupati tradition or Shaiva tradition, which is now found in the forms of Siddha, Shaiva, Kapalika, Bharata, Mukha, and Jaini philosophy. So, in the broader sense of Eastern and Western philosophy, it is said to be the encompassment of all types of philosophy, Eastern and Western, Vedic, non-Vedic, theistic and atheistic. So it covers everything that tries to defend and depend upon the principles of knowledge about the primordial universe, the origin of the soul and the destination, and the causative factor which has combined these various things and who has arranged it, whether it is existing or not, is it accessible or not, is it within us or not, is it ourselves or somebody else, is it attainable here or somewhere else? Dehantrava, Dehantrava. Atmanyantrava, Bhakyava. So there are lots of such philosophical discussions going on. So a national seminar on this Indian philosophical systems and gravity has two major functions. One, it must cover all these various areas. In the second session, no doubt we are going to conduct the same subject with more elucidated problems and solutions, perceptions given by various approaches of various people, with a great concourse and with more valuable discourses. No doubt this inaugural, I am not only inaugurating this seminar, I am inaugurating a series of seminars on the same subject as well as a series of subjects on various disciplines throughout the globe for the dissemination of ultimate knowledge towards. So it may have a small beginning like a forest fire, but it will have its own amazing consequences in dissemination of knowledge and eradication of the murky ignorance in the society. So, in this context, gravity is a very, very small and weaker phenomenon. It is the four major fundamental forces of the world. There are six cosmic ingredients or members of the cosmic society. One is prakriti or matter, shakti or energy, desha or space, kala or time, spirit or soul, which is the chetana, and consciousness or chaitanya. These six members are there, just as there are some members in the Jawaharlal Nehru Technical University and Vedanta Academy. The Cosmic Academy and the Cosmic Technical University consists of six members, the space, time, matter, energy, spirit and consciousness. So both of these sides, either going upon a metaphysical approach or physical approach. Metaphysical approach is an approach which is very much esoteric, in which a person surrenders to a particular conception, believes and then experiences, and in one concept he experiences and then believes. So the experimental and empirical science of modern materialism that asks you to experiment, then experience, then believe and say it was. So here, believe in us, just as falling inside water, at least a limited water, is a requisite for getting the art of speaking. First, getting inside this art of spiritualism and surrendering to a person with a limited background is a primary requisite for getting a knowledge. Then only you can get it experience. So here, belief comes first and experience just. That experience is based on a person's empirical belief. So both of these people, they derived to find out the behavior, origin, behavior and destination of these six units of the cosmos. This cosmic discipline or behavior is understood in different methodologies by different people. First, let us come to the four fundamental forces. One is the gravity, and second is the electromagnetic induction, and third is the nuclear forces being strong and weak in nature. So, the infranuclear forces and ultra-nuclear forces, they form the fundamental, they are known as pillars of modern power, pillars of modern study of power. So, the apprehension of power is based on these four major things. For this, now we have to take a religious scientific club. What we have already decided when we met at least 10 to 12 years before with Dr. Adhar Raman, we have been designing the thing known as symbiosis. That is, read in the biostatistics and biodynamics of modern science. So, understanding not only the attraction of particles towards the earth, there are various types of understanding. Number one, agrogravity between all plants and their ecosystems and related systems. Biogravity between the human beings. The psychogravity, attraction between minds. The ontogravity, understanding between the fundamental objects. Metagravity, understanding between superior and imperceptible objects. Astrogravity, gravity behind all actual objects, which is there in terrestrial mechanism. And geomaterial dynamics and teleparallelism. These are the new concepts of modern science. It requires a special analytical study which cannot be summarized in a small inaugural address. So, studying about the biogravity, theogravity, geogravity, bigravity, antigravity, metagravity, paragravity, infragravity, ultragravity, and etc. etc. on the new dimensions from our side. We have to throw more light upon the attraction of all particles. If there is attraction, attraction is on all things. And attraction gives us automatically repulsion. Motion is the basic cause of the birth. And there is nothing known as inertia. Even in inertia, there is a latent motion. So nothing is there which is wholesome, absolute inertia. Everything has motion. And the motion of a particular thing can be towards an object or away from an object. So away from an object is known as repulsion. Towards an object is known as attraction. It is very common in science. And even in attraction, there are how many attractions? Attraction towards elements of same structure is homogenetic attraction. With different structure is known as heterogenetic attraction. Attraction towards varieties object is polygenetic attraction. Attracting everything and putting control is known as ontogenetic attraction or omnigenetic attraction, which is given by God. So that is what we call as dharana and vidharana. The dharana is known as the control or withholding, that is between the duality of varieties object. And vidharana is the control on all objects by a single person. That is known as vidharana. I want to say about the cosmic withholding process of the Supreme with some basic references to complete this session, inaugural address of this session. First is, Adasyana Bhavatye Kavartitam Yaspin Sarvani Bhuvanani Pastuhu. This is a basic sutra. So, from the originless Brahman, from the navel of the originless Brahman, all positions that I have told, the planetary system, solar system, galaxy system, cluster system, and supercrustal system, all these things are fixed upon the navel, nucleus of the navel of a single Aja, the originless Brahman. That is why God is known as Padmanabha, and that navel notice is said to be the nucleus of the same thing which I have told now. The hierarchy of this attraction is attributed towards the navel notice of the Padmanabha, the Brahman, who is metaphorically understood and metaphysically experienced by great perverts of the Vedic religion. So the second thing is, there is a question in Vedas. अनवर्णे इमे भूमि यम चातु चरोदसि किम वितत्रांतरा भूतम येने मेति हृदय कुठे विश्वाहा हृदय भूमि इति वत्सस्य वेदना. This is a Ayurvedic sutra. The same question which Isaac Newton asked, that was also pondered by, pensively attempted by one more seer, a spiritual scientist known as Vatsa. He asked, anavarne hite bhumi yam chatum charodasi. Space is also withhold. If Earth is withhold like this, there is a controversial or contrary force which withholds the space also. Swaha Prithvi Dham Janayati Deva Ekaha. It is controlled by a single person, single personality of Godhead. So here it is withheld by the force which withholds the sky also. Here it is a force of pull, and that is a force of push which makes both the things coexistingly possible to be in their orbits and respective status and strategy. So it has been asked by Vatsa, and he told Vishnunadi Hrudaya Bhumi, the all-pervading Vishnu, the ubiquitous God, is controlling, withholding and mastering, holding this various strategy of universal status. So that was the answer. Vidhrute. Vidhrute means that is Vishikta Dharanam, Vilakshana Dharanam, Vidhrute. So what is the difference between this gravity and this type of gravity which is known as Dhrita, and that is known as Vidhrita? What is the difference between the Dhrita's portion which is studied in modern science and Vidhrita portion of the Vedas? The Dhrita simply says that it is withhold. Even when Newton, he wrote a letter to Dr. Richard Bentley, he told clearly, all universal planetary motions now could not have spring just from natural forces, but being impressed by an intelligent agent. So that is known as intelligent falling. The concept is known as intelligent falling, intelligent grappling, which is now Stephen C. Mayer, he wrote a detailed book on natural velocity and the background of understanding the cosmic spirit. He has written a book, Stephen C. Mayer, and it has now been kept as given a syllabus in the course known as intelligent design, in which all the insentient beings, like the space, like the limited sky and the planetary system, the earth including, all of these things are insentient, but still they are perfect, punctual and systematic in their self-axis rotation and also revolving around the sun in the orbit. So they must be designed, directed and delegated by a super cosmic brain. So that is an intelligent agent. So even Isaac Newton, he wrote a letter to Bentley saying that apart from the natural forces, I believe that there must be an impression of an intelligent agent. That intelligent agent, as Newton says, that as an intelligent agent, the Vatsa, a spiritual scientist, he clearly says that it is Vishnu, Vishnu, Hrudaya Bhumi. That is all pervading person. He holds everything. So the same philosophy of understanding an intelligent agent behind all the intelligent functions pursued by both of these people, both are scientists. But the scientists, those who are in metaphysical and physical observation, that is it. So regarding this Vishikta Dharana, what is Vishikta Dharana? Number one, Sa Yeta Eva Karoti Iti Vaishityam. He as a single person, he is doing that. So that is great. Number second, without the support of any instrumental benefit or collective responsibility or any other supportive responsibility, he is doing out of his own mind. That is the second thing. Number three, he is holding with his compassion and mercy like a mother. That is Damodara, he used to say that, Damodara. So that he holds all the planets in his cosmic belly. So he is a preserver of the world, even at the time of dissolution, just as we, in the pretext of creation, we used to destroy things. God in the pretext of destruction, in the pretext of creation, we used to destroy things. God in the pretext of destruction, he used to preserve things and recreate with more splendor and vigor. So that is a greatness of God. So that is known as Vishikta Dharana. And number four, even he withholds these uncountable galaxies in the world, he do it without any effort. Without it, by sankalpena karoti, svema hindi pratishtitaha, anayasena karoti, nilaya uddharate mapim. In the Varaha Purana Shloka, it is told that the earth is uplifted and fixed in orbit by the conation, faculty of will of Varaha, the creator of the world, by his sankalpa. Nilaya uddharate mapim. Nilaya means anaya, without any effort. So that primary spirit or primordial spirit alone, without any collective instrumental and supportive responsibilities, out of compassion and mercy towards the spiritual evolution as well as maintaining the global disciplining order that controls, upholds everything, that is known as theogravity or autogravity, and attributing that gravity for understanding the worldly happiness and behavior is known as theogravitational physics. And that will be my subject at the time of the second session, illustrative session, that is going to take place after the few months. Taking this as a final step, We want to conclude with a very simple sloka for understanding the global hierarchy of control. The first is control of all celestial planets. First we see all the celestial planets, the solar system and various planetary systems. Interplanetary control. Then all planets here, their satellites, their control is the planetary attribute. Now, three is the galaxies, various galaxy systems. And especially the solar systems, which is a portion of the galaxy. I told that something also is star. So first we start with the behavior of sky and the celestial planets. So that is known as celestial mechanism. And second is known as satellite mechanism. Third is known as helio or solar mechanism. Fourth is known as a galaxial mechanism. And fifth is known as spatial mechanism. And sixth is known as the geodynamic mechanism. Everything is controlled by the Paramatma. We need not go to the Vedas or Shastras. We used to render the Mahabharata. There are two eyes for Mahabharata. One is Bhagavad Gita, second is Vishnu Rasnama. Bharata Panchamo Veda. So it is glorified. In Vishnu Rasnama, we used to render the Parashuti. It has the hierarchy reference of this order and says that Vasudeva, the primary personality, the supreme personality of Godhead, is a controller. The geo-gravitational physics has been well read and well depicted in the shloka. Yauchya Chandraka Kshatra Kham Disho Bhur Mahodati Vasudevasya Viryena Dhritani Mahatmaha. Yauhu, celestial mechanism, Chandra, cyclic mechanism, Arka, solar mechanism, Nakshatra, galaxy mechanism, Kham Disha, all space and its direction, spatial mechanism, Bhur Mahodati, the liquid mass and solid mass of there, the geodynamic and statistic mechanism, Vasudevasya Viryena Dhritani Mahatmaha. So, Mahatmanaha, Vasudevasya Viryena Dhritani. These things are supported by the fraction of will of the cognitive faculty of the ultimate reality, the adored Vasudeva. Roof Pado Yaschanabh, Piyana Surananda Chandra Surya Uchan Hesre, Karna Vata Harshiro Dhur, Mukhama Vidalama Yasya Vathaya Vakthi, Antastham Yasya Vishwam, Surananda Khadarbo Bhogi Yandhrava Dhrityaihi, Chitram Ram Ramvetetam Sri Bhuvanavatikam Vishnu Vishnu Ramani. I wish this session or seminar a tremendous success to follow the pathway of series of seminars in the dissemination of the values of our traditional as well as the technical wisdom, resulting in the two major requirements of the science and its pursuit. What is the use of studying about the behavior of gravity? First is surety. We can be sure about what is happening so that we can proceed and make our life. Unless we are sure about the surroundings and behavior, we cannot design our life. Surety. Actually, it starts from curiosity. There is curiosity results in surety. Then security. For living a secure life, understanding of the behavior as well as that impending dangers and the possible disasters, one can make his life and the whole spatial evolution and survival secure. Second is security. Third is longevity. By understanding forces, man can expand his longevity and perfect way of living. Fourth is prosperity. Intensifying the process of richness, resulting in all-round happiness and betterment, that is prosperity, and at least to arrive at the perfection standard of global ethics, two things, fraternity and tranquility. We must be developing the global fraternity, which is one of the global consciousness with all people, so as resulting in the tranquility of the society, tranquilization of the society, just to pulling the society from the ugly heads of abnormality, disaster and holocaust, which is both man-made and natural. That is the purpose and purpose of science as well as philosophy. So, we pray to the ultimate God to make such type of seminars more fruitful by dissemination of knowledge. There are several levels of people, benefactors and beneficiaries. Knowledge dissemination is given only to benefactors. All the people here are benefactors, not beneficiaries. Because the mass of the society is ignorant, nescient, negligent and subservient. So to those people, we must create a battalion of benefactors who could just support and approach the society, make them to open their own eyes by their self-realization, to know about their surroundings, their perfection, status and goal. I wish each and every person, participant, organizer and the honorable speakers to the dais, all persons to be more spiritually charged, intellectually sharpened, mentally balanced and physically salubrious to do lot of such things in future in which I can either see, hear or participate in those sessions. Narayan.
Yes, Heidelberg.